I'm an atheist.
I'm a humanist.
It's hard for me to characterize my belief system.
I'm a Buddhist.
I'm a Taoist and naturalist.
Spiritual humanist.
Explorer of liberal Christianity.
A spiritual person.
Deeply agnostic.
We're all pretty different.
Free thinkers.
On a different path.
Many different beliefs.
But we all worship at the same church.
The same church.
But we go to the same church.
Go to the same church.
We all go to the same church.
This is the story of the First Unitarian Church in Dallas. It's not an ordinary story. It's a story about how history lives today. It's a story about a church of action, not reaction. Hospitality and collaboration. It's a story about a church that saves lives and asks its people to go deeper. These are the faces of our people. This is our history. In 1899, Mr. Daniel Limbaugh of Trenton, Mississippi, Dallas's first pastor, spoke to a gathering of Dallasites at the invitation of the rabbi of Temple Emmanuel. Among them were the people who would together create the First Unitarian Church. He said,
"The time has come in the history of Dallas when a broad and liberal Christianity should be declared here. Many souls are hungering and thirsting for religious knowledge, truth, and righteousness. To them, the old dogmas, doctrines, and creeds appear outgrown. These persons are at sea without a chart or compass, and many are making shipwrecks of their religious natures."
If we were going to say what this means for today, it would be this.
What I say that means is that we are a genuinely inclusive community, we are joyfully deep, and we are rational. Genuinely inclusive because we embrace all kinds of folks. Theological diversity or sexual orientation, no exceptions. Joyfully deep means we don't hide from the depth of life, we seek it out as a way of experiencing a more rich and joyful life. And we're also a rational religion, which means that you use your heart, your mind, and your soul. You don't just respond to what the minister says and embrace that as the truth. You have to seek it out. You have to be in dialogue with yourself and others.
Being a Unitarian Universalist means a few things. One of the big ones is affirming for us that no religion has a monopoly on the truth. It's affirming for us that no religion has a monopoly on the truth. It's affirming for us that no religion as a monopoly on the truth. It's affirming for us that no religion has a monopoly on the truth. It means that we talk to other people, that we engage with other churches, other religions. We ask our members to look for a wide variety of sources for guidance, like science, other religions, philosophy, history. What we hope is that our members engage in a humble quest for truth. In fact, we say that the quest for truth is one of our sacraments together. Our religion is about living together well in this life, and so we ask people not to say they believe one thing or another, but to be in right relationship in this world with each other, themselves, and the earth. We care about how you act in this life together.
What we hope that you get when you come here is a community that celebrates you, challenges you, and engages you in meaning, and making meaning in your life. That's really what this place will do.
When people first find out about Unitarianism, it's natural that they should ask questions like, well, what do Unitarians believe about Jesus or the Bible or life after death? Some of the big theological questions. Unfortunately, they are always difficult questions to answer simply because in many ways they are the wrong question. People assume that belonging to a church or a religious community means that you all believe the same thing, whereas in fact a Unitarian congregation isn't predicated on the idea of everybody believing the same thing, and in fact there's a broad range of beliefs that Unitarians have on all theological questions. And so it's very difficult to answer questions easily about what Unitarians believe because there's a wide range of belief. We don't have any creedal test. Our theological spectrum is very broad. It encompasses liberal Christianity, but it also embraces things like modern scientific and philosophical thought, New Age spiritualities, Earth-centered spiritualities, Eastern mysticism. Whatever seems true and relevant and useful, we can gladly incorporate into our Unitarian theology. Also, each individual Unitarian is encouraged to evolve their own theological views as their knowledge and as their experience of life evolves. So, to ask the question, what do Unitarians believe about whatever, is a more complicated question to answer than might first seem. So what unites us is not conformity of belief, but rather commonality of principle and purpose. And we seek to live our religious lives with authenticity and integrity, but not only for the sake of our own spiritual health, but also for the benefit of the wider community. And the element of community is vital because it not only tests our own theological views, keeping us honest and challenging our prejudices and our ideas, but it is in community that we then better serve the world. We've never really gone in for simple catchphrases, but if there was a catchphrase which defined us, it would be deeds, not creeds. That is, if we are to be judged for our religious life, we should be judged on how we live in the world and what we do in the world, not by what we say we believe.
We are not the kind of church that says, if you don't believe in our God, you're going to hell.
We don't teach people what to believe. We teach them how to form their own beliefs.
This is a place where you're welcome, where you're invited into fuller relationship with yourself, with the spirit of life, with other people to build a better world and to build a better you.
Sometimes people wonder if Unitarians are Christians. Certainly it is true that the main stem of our history emerged out of liberal Christianity in this country. And we still are very happy to acknowledge what an important part that is, to recognize the value of Jesus and his ethical teachings have great import and impact in our current thinking. However, we don't think that Jesus was the unique Son of God sent to save us from our sins. Rather, we would, if there was one shared belief about Jesus, it would be that he was a great man in whose life and ministry and death we can find keys to how we should live and how we should act in life and how we should face our own deaths, as there have been other great teachers as well. Some other Christian churches dismiss us because we don't base all of our faith on the saving message of Jesus exclusively. It seems to us that whether or not we are Christian is for an individual to decide how important they place and how central they place the person of Jesus and the Christian tradition. In this country, we live still in a predominantly Christian culture. We are happy to be part of that. Individual Unitarians draw from different wells. One of those wells is the Christian tradition, the liberal Christian tradition of love, the message of Jesus rather than the teachings about Jesus.
It's affirming for us that no religion has a monopoly on the truth. It's affirming for us that no religion has a monopoly on the truth.